Also tonight, a look inside the prosecution's case. We see the evidence that helped convince jurors of Ellis's guilt. And for the first time, hear the phone calls Ellis made after Amber disappeared. Team coverage of our big story continues tonight with KETV News Watch 7's Owen Lay live at the Douglas County Corrections with this story.
Thousands of pages of police reports, hundreds of photos, and excerpts from phone calls made from this jail comprise the evidence in the Roy Ellis murder trial. Prosecutors used all those elements in order to paint Ellis as a man quick to wanting to cover his tracks.
Roy Ellis's own words seem to verify testimony that he had an unusual interest in the search for Amber Harris. Amber's body was found in May 2006 when two men in Hummel Park stumbled across a skull and a patch of red cloth that you see in the left center of this photo. The red cloth was Amber's sweater. She was also wearing her grandmother's necklace. But 6 months earlier, Amber had just disappeared. Ellis had just been arrested on unrelated charges. Of more than 100 phone calls he made from jail, most were to friends who live across the street from 2115 Lake.
I got things I could do, things that's in the way right now that could really, really cause destruction. Something to hurt me. Things I need to get out of here and take care of.
In at least 8 calls, Ellis asks about 2115 Lake and about needing something he called, quote, paperwork.
I need to get up out of here. There's some other things, man, that I need to take care of before I can't talk over the phone. But I see,
oh yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I need to my trail, you know what I'm saying? And I can't live here too much longer.
Ellis never gets much more specific.
But some of this stuff is important. No, and I know I should have never been separated from it. Well, I had it the last time I was there.
Still, prosecutors believe he was talking about the book bag.
It's been, I wanted to say, has it been pretty quiet around over there at Gino's in the house?
Yep.
Ain't been nobody there.
Yeah.
Amber's book bag was found on February 14th, 2006. It contained notebooks with Amber's name, her jacket, and jeans with a mixture of Ellis's and Harris's DNA. Prosecutors say after that date, Ellis never again asked about 2115 Lake.
Now, Ellis already is serving 30-plus years here for a habitual criminal sentence. We should mention Ellis's lawyers declined to comment today, but they will have a chance in the near future to present mitigating circumstances that should try to counter those aggravating circumstances decided on today.
All right, Owen Lay, thanks.
The Harris family reacted to the jury's decision. For the first time, both Melissa and Michael Harris say they are for Ellis being put to death.
The most important part of the justice is him being off the streets. Because she wouldn't want him hurting anybody else in there.
It's like a weight taken off my shoulder, you know, that this finally, we're not going to have to be coming in court and seeing him. And just give us a chance to start putting our family back together.
The Harrises say they expect appeals in the case. So what's next in this case? The fate of Roy Ellis will now be decided by a 3-judge panel. The jury's decision today gave the judge in the case the right to convene the panel. They'll then determine whether Ellis should get the death penalty.